Good morning, everyone. Let's see, already we are discussing about some concepts about oscillations. In the last class, we discussed about the kinetic energy in simple harmonic motion and the potential energy in simple harmonic oscillations. Here, in the last class, the kinetic energy in simple harmonic oscillation is, what is the expression here? Of m omega square a square minus y square. This is the expression for kinetic energy in simple harmonic motions. Here, the potential energy expression, the potential energy is equal to of m omega square a square. This is potential energy expression. I'm already tell that the kinetic energy is maximum at mean position and the minimum at extreme position. In case of potential energy, the potential energy is maximum at extreme position and the kinetic energy is minimum at extreme position, and as well as the potential energy is minimum at mean position. Why? Because the expression is of m omega square a square minus y square. At mean position, the displacement of the particle is zero. Then what's the expression here? Of m omega square a square. That means the kinetic energy is maximum at mean position. Here, the potential energy is equal to of m omega square a square. For example, at mean position. At mean position becomes y equal to zero. Y equal to 0 is nothing but the potential energy is maximum at extreme position. Is it right? Okay. Now, we are discussing about the total energy equation in simple harmonic motion. The total energy equation in simple harmonic motion. Here, the particle executes two energies. The one is the potential energy of the simple harmonic motion. Another one is the kinetic energy of simple harmonic motion. Is it right? Here, the potential energy is an account for the change in displacement. As the displacement increases, the potential energy is also increases. And as well as the kinetic energy. The kinetic energy is responsible for the velocity of the particle or a body. Is it right? Already. Then, the total energy is equal to the sum of potential energy and kinetic energy. Is it right? The sum of potential energy plus kinetic energy. Already we know that the potential energy of the particle in simple harmonic motion, kinetic energy of the particle in a simple harmonic oscillation. Then we have to find the total energy in a simple harmonic oscillations or motions. Is it right? Here, what is the expression for potential energy? The potential energy is equal to, what is the expression here? Of m omega square a square. Is it right? Of m omega square a square. The potential energy. Is it right? Then what about kinetic energy? The kinetic energy is equal to of m omega square a square minus y square. Is it right? Where m is the mass of the particle, omega is the angular velocity, where a is the maximum displacement, or a is nothing but amplitude. Is it right? Then here, m is the mass of the body, omega is the angular velocity, a is the amplitude, and y is displacement of the particle. Then substitute these equations. In equation number 1, for example, this is equation number 1. then equation 1 becomes the total energy is equal to the potential energy is of m omega square a square. Is it right? Plus of m omega square a square minus y square. Here I can write of m omega square a square, which is at extreme position. If the point is not reached to the extreme position, then its displacement is y. That means the potential energy at any point in the simple harmonic oscillation, it can be taken as y square. Is it right? At any point, it can be taken as y square. This is nothing but what it can be written as y square. At any point, at extreme position or half m omega square a square. At any particular distance, of half m omega square y square. Then, by using calculation, what is means? Half m omega square y square plus half m omega square into a square. Half m omega square a square minus into plus minus half m omega square y square. Here, half m omega square y square minus half m omega square y square get cancelled. The remaining is half m omega square a square. This is the total energy expression in simple harmonic oscillations. Is it right? Then, at any instant of time, for example, at any instant of time is nothing but at t equal to 0, at t equal to t by 4, at t equal to t by 2, at t equal to t. Is it right? Then at any instant of time, we can discuss. For example, here, at any instant, at instant of time, t equal to 0. T equal to 0 is nothing but, for example, we can take one simple pendulum which is considered at a point, fixed point, yes. This is mean position, O. This is extreme position, plus A. It can be oscillated from mean position to extreme position. Is it right? At T equal to 0, the displacement of the particle is 0. At t equal to 0, displacement of the particle is 0. Is it right? Then here, at t equal to 0, the displacement becomes 0. Then the kinetic energy becomes, kinetic energy, the kinetic energy is equal to half m omega square a square minus, at t equal to 0, displacement, y equal to 0. Then half m omega square a square, y becomes 0. Then kinetic energy is equal to half m omega square a square. Then what about potential energy? Then the potential energy is equal to half m omega square y square. When y equal to 0, it becomes 0 square. Then the potential energy is equal to 0. At which position? At time t equal to 0 and the displacement 0. There is no any displacement of the particle. The particle is at a mean position. Then the potential energy is 0. The kinetic energy is half m omega square a square. Then what about total energy? Substitute that one. Then the total energy equal to, the total energy equal to potential energy plus kinetic energy, half m omega square a square. Then the total energy is equal to half m omega square a square. At which position? Mean position. The displacement of the particle is 0. The time taken will be 0. The next we go for the another instant of time. Which one? For example, at extreme position, this is t equal to 0. Then here it oscillates from mean position to extreme position. The time taken is t is equal to t by 4. Is it right? The time taken is t equal to t by 4. Then its displacement. What is this displacement? Y is equal to a. Why? Because it reaches the maximum displacement. That means the particle is at extreme position. If the particle is at extreme position, the displacement of the particle is a. Is it right? Then substitute those equations at instant of time. Can I write this here? Okay. At instant of time, t equal to t by 4. When t equal to t by 4, the particle displacement is y equal to a, where a is the maximum amplitude. Is it right? Then what is the potential energy? What is the kinetic energy? Let's see now. The potential energy equal to half m omega square a square. Why? Because a square, the displacement is a. That's why half m omega square into y square, where y is equal to a into a square. This is potential energy. Then what about kinetic energy? Then kinetic energy equal to half m omega square a square minus y square. Y is nothing but a square. It can be zero. That's why kinetic energy equal to zero. Then what about total energy? Where total energy is equal to potential energy of m omega square a square plus kinetic energy is zero. That's why total energy of the simple harmonic motion is of m omega square a square. This is the expression for total energy when the particle displacement at a time t by 4. Are you understand? Okay, next we go for the another concept, the relation between potential energy, kinetic energy as well as total energy, how it varies from time to time. For example, t equal to 0, t equal to t by 4, t is equal to t by 2, t equal to t. How it varies by graphical representation, we have to know that. And the total energy is always constant. At the extreme position also, total energy is half m omega square a square. At the mean position also, total energy is half m omega square a square. Okay, na? Then the graphical representation. Graphical representation. The graph is like this. This is time taken. This is at a time t equal to 0. This is t by 4. That means mean position to extreme position. This is t by 2. This one is 3t by 4. And this one is t. Total time taken, time period. Okay, na? Then first we know about the kinetic energy. And then potential energy, and then total energy. How it varies the kinetic energy in a simple pendulum or simple harmonic motion? For example, at time t equal to 0, let's see here, pendulum, extreme position. At t equal to 0, the kinetic energy is maximum. Why it is maximum? At kinetic energy, at mean position is maximum. And you understand? Then the kinetic energy is maximum at t equal to 0. And then if the particle is oscillated from here to here in an extreme position, kinetic energy, is it minimum or maximum? Minimum. That is nothing but the kinetic energy is 0 at t by 4. Is it right? Then after, again the particle is oscillated to the mean position at a time taken t by 2. That mean position t by 2, that means the kinetic energy is maximum at mean position. Again, the kinetic energy is maximum at T by 2. Are you understand? T by 2 is nothing but the particle should be at mean position. T equal to 0 is nothing but the particle is at mean position. If the particle is T by 4, the particle is at extreme position. On extreme position, the kinetic energy is 0. Then, again the graph is like this. Again it comes to 0, again it goes to increases as it's going to mean position. Where T by 2 or T by 4 is extreme position, kinetic energy is 0. T by 2 is minimum mean position, kinetic energy is maximum, like this. Then you go for potential energy. How it varies the potential energy? Already we know that the potential energy is 0. At which position? At mean position. And the potential energy is maximum at extreme position. Again, the graph is like this. Are you understand? Then, T by 2 is nothing but at mean position, the potential energy is 0. Are you understand? Again, the T is nothing but total time taken. Matte again, particle mean position ke barutte. Mean position by the potential energy enagutte 0. Are you understand? This is the graph between the potential energy and kinetic energy. Again, what about total energy? I'm already told that the total energy is constant at every point in the simple pendulum or simple harmonic motions. Is it extreme position? The total energy is constant. It is it mean position? The total energy is constant. It is always constant. That's why the total energy is always maximum at every time interval, at every position. At T by 4 second, the particle is at extreme position, then it exhibits the total energy is maximum. At T by 2 second, the particle at mean position, then it exhibits the total energy is maximum. This is total energy. This is total energy. This is, which one is? Potential energy. This one is kinetic energy. This is a graphical representation of which one? Kinetic energy, potential energy, as well as total energy within the time intervals. Are you understand? Okay? Let's we go for the another concept, most important. That means here we are discussing about the total energy. The most important for PU purpose, they are asking for 5 marks. Next, we have to write the total energy expression and derive that equation. And then you write the graphical representation, must and should. It is most important for 5 marks, for most important. Then we go for the another concept, the time period of simple pendulum. The time period of simple pendulum. 5 marks for PUC, the most important. In the coming preparatory or coming annual examination, they may ask. Okay? Here, let us consider one simple pendulum which is fixed at a point S. The length of the simple pendulum is taken as L, small l, and its bob is connected to the string. Its mass is M. Is it right? Then, when the particle is displaces from mean position to extreme position, mean position to extreme position, the force will be applied on that bob. The various force is applied on that body or particle. For example, if the simple pendulum is oscillating like this, oscillating like this, which is displaces x. It can be taken as x. The displacement is taken as x. The angle, it can be taken as theta. If the particle is displaces from mean position to extreme position, the various forces acting on that body, that various forces is like this. The tension along, for example, this point is taken as P, this is S. The tension along PS, along the string, the string mulaka, the tension act aagta hote towards the S, P mate S. Then again one more force is there, that is that its weight is vertically downward, that is mg. Is it right? The mass of the body is m, acceleration due to gravity is g. That's why its force F is equal to ma, already you know that. Then F is equal to acceleration due to gravity, it can taken as a equal to g. Then F is equal to mg. The downward force is acting on that body. Are you understand? There are two forces acting on this. One is tension T, another one is mg, the force towards the downward direction. Is it right? Then again, this downward force, it can be resolved into two components. First you write that one. There are various forces acting on a body. The first one is tension T along PS. Tension along PS. Again, the second one is the downward force. The downward force F equal to mg along downward. F equal to mg. This is a downward force. Next, this force is can be resolved into two components. This force, the force mg, is resolved into two components. Two components. The first one is mg cos theta along PA. Later I will tell you. The second one is mg sin theta along PB. How it comes? Already we are discussing the resolution of component, resolvement of vectors. How it comes? For example, this is P. This mg is resolved into two components along PA, along PB. This is angle theta. This is displacement x. Can I take this in separate? I will explain how it comes, these resolved components mg cos theta and mg sin theta. I will take the separate diagrams. First, you take the point P. This is along A. This is downward force mg. This is angle theta. This is displacement x. Then here, along PA, we can take cos theta. Is it right? Here, this is adjacent side. This is hypotenuse side. This is opposite side. Is it right? Then here, cos theta is equal to, this is angle theta. Cos theta is equal to, what is right? Adjacent by hypotenuse. Adjacent side we don't know, that's why it can be taken as y. Cos theta is equal to y by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is taken as mg. Is it right? Then y is equal to, what can we write? Y is equal to mg cos theta along PA. Along PA. then along sine normal functions, where sine theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite can be taken as x displacement, x by hypotenuse means mg. Therefore, x is equal to mg sin theta. I understand how these components are resolved by mg. Okay, need not to write all those things in derivations, but understanding purpose, we have to know how it components are came from the force mg. Then, here, this force is taken as mg cos theta, and this force is taken as mg sin theta. This is nothing but the restoring force when the particle is displaces from mean position to extreme position. Again, it comes back to mean position. Simple pendulum oscillate aagta ide. This is extreme position, it is mean position. If the particle is moving like this, if the particle reaches the extreme position, again it comes back to the mean position. That means we are applying some forces. They are influencing a force. That is nothing but restoring force. The restoring force. What is the restoring force here? This is the restoring force. Again, the particle comes to mean position. That force is mg sin theta. Restoring force, where F is equal to minus mg sin theta. Why it is taken as negative sign? Why? Because the displacement and the force are in opposite direction. Again, the displacement is going like this. The force will be back towards the mean position. They are both are in opposite direction. That's why F is equal to minus mg sin theta. Are you understanding? Then here, where we can take, this is the angle theta, very, very small angle. Is it right? Then here, where sin theta is equal to, by using trigonometric functions in mathematics, when the angle between two components is very, very minimum, then it can be taken as sin theta is equal to theta, cos theta equal to theta, in trigonometric function. That's why where sin theta is equal to, it can be taken as theta. That's why sin theta is nothing but opposite by hypotenuse. Here, this is angle theta, hypotenuse, adjacent, opposite. Opposite here, what do we take? X by hypotenuse here taken as L. Is it right? This is nothing but theta is equal to X by L. Substitute this equation in N, where F is equal to, what is written as? Minus mg theta, in place of sin theta, it can be written as theta, that is equal to minus mg, theta is nothing but X by L. This is equation number 1. Are you understanding? Then we go for next continue. Already we know that the restoring force in simple harmonic motion, where F is equal to, F is directly proportional to displacement in opposite direction. Otherwise, it can be written as F is equal to minus K into Y, where K is the proportionality constant. Is it right? Where already we know that the proportionality K is equal to M omega square. Substitute this equation, where F is equal to minus M omega square Y. This is the restoring force in simple harmonic motion. But here, in the previous diagram, the displacement, it can be taken as X, not Y. Either you can take Y displacement, then it can be written as M omega square Y. Any variables you can take, either Y, either X, or either any alphabetics. Then minus M omega square X. This is equation number 2. Compare equation number 1 and 2. What can you write? Equation 2 is F is equal to minus M omega square X. Equation 1 is minus mg x by L. Compare these two. What can you write? Minus m omega square x is equal to minus m g x by L. Is it right? Then by my mathematical calculation, where xx get cancelled, minus minus get cancelled, mm get cancelled. Remaining is omega square is equal to g by l. What is the relation between angular velocity and time period? Where omega is equal to 2 pi, otherwise, where omega is equal to square root of g by l. Square root on both sides, then square root and square get cancelled, remaining is square root of g by l. Omega is nothing but 2 pi by t, that is equal to g by l. Is it understanding? Then t is equal to, next we have to find the time period of simple pendulum. In terms of time period, we have to derive the equations. That's why where time period is equal to, what can we write? Where t is equal to, cross multiplication mark. Where t can be, goes to right hand side, square root of g by l is denominator. Then t is equal to, the final equation I will write, where 2 pi into square root of l by g. This is the time period equations in simple pendulum. Very, very most important, 5 marks for PU examinations. Must and should you have to learn. Okay, some cases we are discussing about the simple pendulum, how it is varies, how it is variations in if the elevator is moving upward or downward. Let's we discuss. First you take, otherwise the note you have to take. Note. Before going to note, the time period is depends on its length of the pendulum. How it is depends? Where t is directly proportional to square root of l. Is it right? T is directly proportional to square root of l. If the length of the pendulum is increases by n times, then the time period is increases by square root of n times of its length. Are you understanding? That means the time period is depending upon its length. And as well as the time period is also depending upon acceleration due to gravity. Are you understanding? The next, the variation concept. For example, the first one, if the simple pendulum is placed in elevator, elevator is nothing but lift. If the simple pendulum is placed on that lift, for example here, this is lift, here is a simple pendulum. If the lift is moving upward, if the lift is moving upward, what is the weight of the person? W is equal to m into g. If the lift is moving upward, what is the acceleration due to gravity? W is equal to m into g plus a. Are you understanding? Again, the acceleration of the body is moving downward. That means the W is equal to m into g plus a. Same as it is in the first case, if the elevator is moving upward, then the acceleration is taken as a is equal to, as otherwise the time period t is equal to 2 pi into l by g plus a, square root of. If the same elevator is moving downward, what is the acceleration to gravity? Where a is equal to, otherwise g is equal to minus a. Then what about its time period? T is equal to 2 pi into l by g minus a. Why? Because here the g dash is equal to g minus a. Here g dash is equal to g plus a. When the lift is, acceleration is taken as negative minus a. The third point. In freely falling body, then g is equal to, otherwise the acceleration of the body is equal to g. Then what is the equation? T is equal to 2 pi into l by g minus g. That is equal to 0. G minus g is nothing but infinity. G minus g is 0. Then 2 pi into 1 by 0 is nothing but infinity. If the time period is infinity, what is its frequency? Already we know that f is equal to 1 by t. 1 by infinity is nothing but 0. The number of oscillations per second is 0. That means on the freely falling body, otherwise acceleration due to gravity is equal to acceleration of the body, then there is no any oscillation in simple pendulum. Are you understanding? This is the third case. The fourth case is there. If the lift or elevator is moving in constant velocity or constant speed in an elevator, then the time period for simple pendulum is always same as it is 2 pi square root of L by G when the elevator is moving at constant velocity or constant speed. I understand these are the concepts about the time period of simple pendulum. Most important, you have to learn first. Here, the oscillation chapter, this is the last concept of time period. In the next class, we can discuss some problems, neat problems, objective problems. We have to discuss it about based on time period of simple pendulum and time period of one more loaded spring as well as total energy of the simple harmonic motion. Okay? Okay. Thank you.